So, we're going to now introduce a concept called a player's dominant strategy. So, a dominant strategy is one that gives me the best possible result no matter what the other player does. It's my best option no matter what the other player does. And you can go ahead and look at this matrix and try to figure out whether either player has a dominant strategy. And it won't always be the case that anyone has a dominant strategy. In fact, often it won't. Games where everyone has a dominant strategy are often relatively boring. So let's look at it here. So the way to look at this is, if target plays low, what should Kmart do? So if target plays low, we know that we're in this column right here. And if we're in this column, Kmart has a choice between playing high and getting 2, and playing low and getting 5. So if we're in this column here, if target plays low, Kmart should play low. What if target plays high? In that case, Kmart has a choice between playing low and getting 8, and playing high and getting 0. So, in this case, if target plays high, Kmart should play low. So yes, Kmart does have a dominant strategy in this game. So the dominant strategy for Kmart is to play low. What about target? Well, if Kmart plays high, what will target want to do? Well, if Kmart plays high, then we're in this row down here, and target will want to play high so that they can get 4 instead of 3. What if Kmart plays low? If Kmart plays low, then when target gets to choose which column we're in this top row, and they would want to choose high. So in fact, in this game, target does not have a dominant strategy. Notice the dominant strategy is not about whether or not you beat the other player. And actually, in game theory, again, we assume that people only care about their own payoffs. So target wants the highest possible payoff. It doesn't matter that much to target if Kmart makes a bunch of money. They just care about how much they make. So Kmart has a dominant strategy. Target actually always makes more money, but has no dominant strategy. And I wanted to make sure that I drew that distinction between who gets more points or who gets more profits and the idea of a dominant strategy. Now, of course, if Target knows that Kmart has a dominant strategy, Target knows that Kmart will play its dominant strategy. And if Target knows Kmart will play its dominant strategy, then we can get a prediction of what Target will do, namely, Target will choose to play high. So even though Target doesn't have a dominant strategy, the way this game's going to play out, the fact that Kmart has a dominant strategy is going to make Target's behavior predictable. So you can see how this whole idea of strategic behavior works, where you have to try and get inside the other firm's head and that kind of thing. So that's this game, and in the next video segment, I'll do a little bit more advanced game.